Hey everybody, I just wanted to take a minute here and talk about a subject I really have enjoyed over the years, and that's Mr. Gene Roddenberry, Mr. Star Trek himself. Probably one of the greatest prophets, I think, of the last century or so. There's only been a few people, H.G. Wells, Jules Verne, that were capable of predicting the future, or shall we say, influencing the future like Mr. Gene Roddenberry did. My little cell phone here is nothing but a Star Trek communicator. You know, I mean, let's face it, you know, beam me up, Scotty. So much of our everyday lives now, from our personal computers to, I just cannot even think of all the things that have been influenced by the original Star Trek TV series. But what really gets me is that Gene Roddenberry had more imagination than was required for just doing a science fiction TV series. The man really thought through a future that had the potential to be a better world. His outlook that so much strife and stuff in the world could be eliminated, and that people could work together and achieve goals that were beyond normal imagination. He really showed us the way to live in the future, not only on a technological basis, which is just absolutely awesome. I mean, they are now literally working with principles of warp drive. I recently saw where cloaking is now a known fact. DNA replication, clones, all this. I won't say he originated these concepts, but let's just say he brought them into our living rooms and made them very commonplace. Like I say, Jules Verne, H.G. Wells are some of the very few in just this last century or two. And then you got to go clear back to Nostradamus and stuff to be able to see people who actually saw the future so clearly. Frankly, it's just a little frightening from my perspective because while I'm very aware that it's a fantasy world and that this is science fiction and stuff, it's very much like in the movie Journey to the Center of the Earth, the most recent one they had, where they're talking, they're down in the middle of the planet and they're talking about, wow, this is just like the book. And one of the people in the principals in the movie goes, well, if all of the rest of this is real, well, then what about the scary monster parts? And that's kind of a valid point here, that Roddenberry was not beyond imagining monsters in the deep darks of space. So it makes you wonder if some of the, shall we say, darker sides of Roddenberry's world will someday come back to haunt us as well. I don't mean to imply anything out of line or anything, but over the years, a lot of people have put up suggestions that we've been influenced by alien cultures. And if you wanted to influence the Earth and you wanted to get us ready for aliens from space, Gene Roddenberry would have been a great way to do it. I mean, he made the concept of space travel look like it was going to be damn fun. I mean, it wasn't going to be the frightening booster ride that we see for our astronauts now and stuff. It wasn't going to be the little tiny jump to a little piece of rock that happens to be floating up in our sky. It was going to be jumping to other star systems and alien worlds. And it has the potential to be a wondrous thing. I've seen so much in science in my lifetime that I can actually remember the days when there was no such thing as a man in space. There was no such thing as a man on the moon. It had never occurred. It was all science fiction. If you talked about a man on the moon, it was only in terms of science fiction. It hadn't even been seriously thought of other than as cartoon fodder. It really, in just a few decades, has come full circle from being just a person's bit of wild imagination, whether it's H.G. Wells or whatever, to actually being us walking on the face of another planetoid, for lack of a better word, a moon, and having serious conversations about interplanetary travel, going to Mars and maybe other places. In my youth, I had hoped I would see that in my day. I can remember when Star Trek, the original TV series, came out. At that time, I believe there was Lost in Space and a few others that kind of treated space travel in a semi-comical way, but not Star Trek. Star Trek was pretty serious business. Fascinating. And like I say, it's influenced people all across the planet now. When you go in, the medical instruments that so many people see, computer tracking systems for aircraft and vehicles, a lot of this stuff has been generated off of Star Trek. Now, of course, Roddenberry was smart enough that he consulted NASA, and a lot of this came from the rather brilliant scientists they had in the space program back when the original Star Trek series came out. So it's kind of a double-edged sword that you could argue whether or not the technology for phasers, communicators, and so on and so forth have been brought into our world because of Roddenberry, or whether Roddenberry could only see the handwriting on the wall and realize that these things probably were going to happen anyway. I tend to believe that it may have happened, but it wouldn't have been as aggressive. It wouldn't have, shall we say, evolved as quickly if Roddenberry hadn't just showed it to us right in our face and said, this is how you do it. The man was brilliant. But be that as it may, I think I've rambled on long enough and I've given you the impression, which I intended to, that I am a Trekkie. I really love the original series. The rest of the different series they had, Deep Space Nine, so on and so forth, really didn't do much for me. I'm an original Star Trek fan, and that's been about it. I watched some of the other shows, don't get me wrong, but just not with the fervor that I had when I watched the original Star Trek series, and still enjoy to this day. I will say there's been one exception, and that was the new Star Trek movie. That thing just impressed the heck out of me. They did a brilliant job of bringing the old cast back to life. Very impressive. If you haven't seen it, please do. Well, I don't really know how to close this other than to say, beam me up, Scotty. Gotta go. See you later. Bye.